surrenders the first.
One.
I think it's interesting to look at physicality in table tennis, how different body types have different skill sets and have to play around that. Dima's good a step behind the table.
One all.
Pace, sharpness, and the sting.
Yeah, for me, Togami, again, if you look at Maharu Yoshimura, a predecessor of his who's played incredibly well recently, these are two players that are a bit fluid and lanky in their style, really quick and snappy.
Tell me a little bit about the Dima serve here.
He's got some of the most iconic serves in the game. Gets low to the table, learned from his father, Michael, back in the day, who was big through the USSR times.
It's two in a row that worked nicely for him. Crowd loving this.
We haven't seen his tomahawk as much. It'll come out from time to time, and he can make it look like it's straight side spin, and it's some of the heaviest underspin you've ever dealt with. Bottom of the net, but the pros at this level know it well. And those serves are Dmitry Ovcharov serves. Again, some of the iconic serves that we'll see. It's nice when someone has those signatures that you can recognize even in a silhouette.
And right now, it's hard work for Shunsuke Togami, surrendering both of his serves and dropping 4 points back in this opening game. Beautifully captured by our camera there. That's an incredible technique. So parallel to the table.
It's a very unusual serve. And he gets a lot of top and side spin on that last one.
1-7.
One thing about the grip when you're serving, if you can loosen up at the point of contact, you get more racket speed. You don't have quite the backstroke or the full swing that you would have on a mid-shot or mid-rally shot.
We're talking about rallies there. He's won some quick points, and then he picks up another there. And that's a much-needed point there, but he had to work hard for that, Shunsuke Togami.
He made it look easier than it was. Few people can end a rally with Dima in position here. That ball just sunk. The bottom dropped out. Quick topspin shot, drive early.
Wonderful.
A3.
Wonderful from Shunsuke Togami, but boy, he's got to work for anything he's going to get right now.
Right now, Dima's controlling the baseline of the table, staying closer. If this point is played over and over again, Dima's going to win the majority of those rallies.
Four, eight.
Now, in terms of the never give up attitude, Shunsuke Togami had suffered one of the most devastating comebacks against him in the World Championships here in China in Chengdu. With Wang Chuqin, he was up 9-4 for what would have been one of the most incredible victories in modern history. And Wang Chuqin came back to win that game in the next two. Shunsuke Togami, I think, came back tougher, stronger, and with a never give up attitude.
Four, nine.
Well, he's gonna have to come up with a comeback. Nothing like that epic you just detailed, but he's got to come up with something in this first game here because Dima's just got himself into a strong position.
Dima's incredibly mentally tough.
And he finds himself on the verge of this one now. Game point for the first time goes his way, and he's got a bunch of them too. Tomahawk.
11-4.
Changes it, same result. With that serve that closed out the first.
Love one.
One thing I can say about the professionals is their ability to read serve. It's a matter of survival. The first time almost anyone faced Dima's tomahawk serve, 3 times in a row they put it into the net.
Well, he went back to what had worked for him, but not this time. Flicks it long. Two love to Shunsuke Togami at the start of the second.
A nice adjustment on the receive there. Shunsuke Togami doing a wonderful job to shorten it up, leave it out in front on that forehand side for Dima to step around.
2-1.
I'm still excited thinking about that list of movers and shakers. We've got some really big up-and-coming stars here.
Yeah, you're absolutely right.
1-3.
We've seen them in action here, and we already saw this morning some really high-quality stuff. Sora Matsushima got himself into the groove and got going earlier on. Zhang Peng, brilliant, absolutely brilliant. Power game we saw earlier on today.
2-3.
Talking about power.
4-2.
I can't remember the last time, if ever, that I've seen Dima pull out a shovel serve. I'm sure it's happened. It's just incredibly rare. A lot of players in the game, I'm going to say the women of Japan and the women of China, use this serve. Some of the men from Japan, it's not so common, but Dima's got his fair selection of serves. That one didn't work out for him. Shunsuke Togami doing quite well.
4-3.
The rich history Dima has alongside Timo over the years, what he said in his message was, I will fight, brother. We will fight till the end.
Oh, there he is. Look at that reaction. Yeah, Timo was huge earlier on, picked up a victory, and boy, oh boy, he was the talk of this arena. Beautiful post-match interview. Gave the crowd a yes, yeah. Just wonderful from Timo. And Dima's turning it on as well.
So the point before this, we saw Dima cover the middle quite well with the forehand. Shunsuke Togami is going to be looking for that elbow. As a taller player stands across from him, and we have a timeout now.
Power this time on the backhand from Dima. He's got to come up with something. And you called him range earlier on, and he used all of that length to his advantage.
We saw this with Jun Ji-hee just earlier. When you recognize exactly what you have to do, there's no hesitation. That's the type of play Togami's doing. He's coming in with clear intention and finding the openings early.
Using those long levers to his advantage. Six apiece now in the second.
This is incredible pace with the backhand inside the baseline to generate that much power. You think power, you think brute force. But again, how you bring everything together, that lanky arm, the snap of the wrist, the timing just perfect. And he's in front now by one, Togami.
8-6.
Make that two.
Think it caught the back edge of the table.
Well,
they're going to change
that. Yep. Yep.
Seven apiece is my guess at this point.
Yep.
7-0.
Yep, you're right.
This is weird. I don't even know what to do now. I've never been here before.
Not this time.
8-7.
And this is a whole lot tighter, this game.
Yeah, Togami's doing a wonderful job of opening here. That first shot, the quality in your first opening attack. It's not necessarily who opens first, it's the quality on that. Sets it up well, Togami. The long serve does everything right, but Dima bringing it back to baseline with a fast serve coming in. He doesn't need to do as much to the ball.
And how about that? Pace again in the match.
This is a blast from the past here, what Dima has been able to do for the last decade. In 2014, we saw him 3-0 Zhang Jiko with backhands just like that. If he can stay in near the table, get that authoritative backhand in quickly.
And now he finds himself with a couple of game points for this second to put himself in a really powerful position.
The delicate touch on that, again, loosens up the grip. Takes most of the spin off the ball, just puts light underspin on it, so when Togami lifts, there's not too much backspin to lift. Hence the ball carries long. Serves with Togami here. Ocha Jayo, I love it. It's good when you have a Mandarin nickname. Most of the pros do, some of them famous like Dima.
Left. 8-10.
Keeping that racket hand dry, Shunsuke Togami.
And it works, saves one of them.
So fluid, parallel to go with it.
You caught it earlier, that whip. Top spin on that backhand.
Left. 9. 10.
All sorts of tricks to keep himself calm between points, from the fingernails to the ball rolling the edge of the racket.
But he can't save this one. Nine. And it's an 11-9 second game win there for Dima. Six medals since 2008. I think that's what it is in Olympics. That's impressive stuff here.
More than most, you would say.
Yep.
Love two.
There was a lot of drama in terms of the predictions, and even still, especially with Patrick Franziska's incredible run in Saudi Arabia recently. Germany runs deep. Dima, one of the leaders of the team.
Well, having made one from behind his back, Togami's unable to see that one through.
Figuratively speaking. I was like, did you see something that I didn't? Have I missed a behind the back shot?
No, he had to turn a long, long way to get back, maybe the second shot in the rally there.
Yeah, good coverage on the backhand side, no doubt about it. And tied up here, Togami looking to get an early lead. Had one in last game, 4-2 at the first towel break. Togami's good behind the table, but he's just going to be that much less threatening as anyone would. Short game in near the table is where he's going to have to count on winning points.
And we're seeing that fist pump more and more now from the German, who holds a slender lead in the third. Remember, two up already.
4-2.
So the opposite scoreline of what we saw last game at the first towel break. I'm actually excited. In Chongqing, there's such a rich history, of course, for table tennis here in China that they know all the players, but this is a new experience to have such a massive event in this city.
Yeah, the first ever southwestern Chinese city to host a WTT series event. Banan District, also known as a hotbed for table tennis, even in this municipality.
But nah, nah, nah.
Not high enough. 4-2.
Dima doesn't like it. Facial story.
Issue raised.
16 story. Centimeters. 16 centimeters out of the palm of the hand from the time it leaves the palm. It's not how far it falls. It's how high it goes after you let go.
And that was the first of those calls I think we've seen today.
It was interesting. I mean, Dima, that was a very confident service toss. It wasn't anyone trying to adjust too much for a call. It was almost as if he said, say it again. Say it again. I dare you. Fault me.
I'm still enjoying Facial Story. But 6-2 it is to the German, who is getting in stronger and stronger position as far as this match is concerned.
He's got very unique technique, Dima, that backhand. I haven't seen anyone do it quite like Dima. It can often be quite damaging to the opponent. Good combination here. One to the middle, then the wide backhand. Gets Dima to shift a little bit into the center and then takes him back to the wide backhand corner. When he's a step behind the table, it's more ground to cover.
Should he go on to win this one, round of 16, opposition would be either Hugo Calderano or Truls Morgaard.
Truls, a teammate for Dima.
Another look.
He did the right thing to keep playing. When you hear let, point is stopped. So I think Dima just wanted to be extra sure here. Ooh. Well, if it caught it, it was tough to see in that replay, possibly on the way up.
Too good. Three. Too good from Dima. He's now won 12 of the last 16 points. He's on a roll when it matters most.
Smart play here, Togami catching it on the rise. If a lob isn't right near the baseline, players know exactly what to do. That one wasn't a bad lob. Togami really taking his chances, stepping around.
Yeah, how was that recovery from Dima there? He took himself by surprise.
Oh, the ball kid. Ball kid had a sweet blushing moment there as Lars Hillshire watches on. Job not done yet for the German.
But it's been a commanding showing so far from the German.
Five, eight.
Takes a lot to recover from a ball like this. Watch Dima's body weight shift here. Chase gets up on one foot, has to completely replant himself.
Time out.
Conversation about the receive game. Again, I couldn't hear it clearly. My German nor my Japanese are exceptional. But the body language, all this. Interesting, we've got some Korean chants here for Ovcha as well.
Eight,
he's come back off the timeout with a couple of important points here as Togami. Just trying to claw some kind of a foothold in this match before it's too late.
Continue play. A7.
Big point here, much needed. First one since his timeout at 8-5. Again, not the way Shunsuke Togami can count on winning a point. Reactionary from behind the table, but placed well into the middle, and a serious momentum shift here for Shunsuke Togami.
Yeah, six of the last 8 points, but it was absolutely essential.
Still is.
Oh, what a point from below the table. Dima pulls it out for match point.
Yeah, that was a scraping save here. He was not in the position he wanted to be. This is where Shunsuke shouldn't have to worry about Dima, but from below the table, as mentioned, this camera angle will make it so clear. That shot was a sniper, a missile from under the table.
I
just
knew
found
you'd love
its way.
That. I knew you'd love that. Under the table, sets up a match point. But does he finish it now?
Nine.
Saves one, match point.
Eight,
And Stima, and it's done in style. And he flashes a winner to make it a 3-3 love.